Know who to talk to and who to listen to, meaning our analysis is unbiased with absolutely no spin.
Unspun World, tonight at 8:30 on the BBC News Channel.
This is BBC News. I'm Joanna Gosling. The headlines at midday. An historic moment for nationalists in Northern Ireland as Sinn Féin is on course to become the largest party at Stormont.
I'm Anita McVeigh in Belfast on day two of the count, and in the next few minutes I'll be speaking to the former Northern Ireland Secretary, Julian Smith.
Across the rest of the UK, the Conservatives have lost almost 500 seats in the local elections, with Labour and the Liberal Democrats taking control of a number of councils. The SNP remain the largest party in Scottish councils, with Labour overtaking the Conservatives to finish second. Labour was the biggest winner in Wales, where the Conservatives lost more than 80 seats. In other news, more attempts are being made to rescue civilians trapped at a steelworks in the besieged Ukrainian city of Mariupol. 50 people were taken out of the city yesterday. Chelsea get their new owners. Terms have been agreed with the consortium led by the American Todd Boehly. Good afternoon, welcome to BBC News. Sinn Féin is on track to win the most seats in the Northern Ireland Assembly for the first time ever, signalling an historic shift in the political landscape. We can go live to Belfast and get the latest from Anita McVeigh. Anita.
Thank you very much, Joanna. And yes, welcome back. As you say, Sinn Féin on course to emerge as the biggest party from these elections. It's a huge moment for nationalism, undoubtedly, with constitutional questions raised by that over the question of a United Kingdom or a United Ireland. Sinn Féin, of course, the nationalist party that wants ultimately to see a United Ireland. But of course, there are more immediate and pressing concerns expressed by voters on the doorsteps, irrespective of their political backgrounds.